Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we'll be solving this puzzle called floor, ceil, and R int. Let's go through this. So here you can see about floor, ceil, and R int. Okay. So this is the description, and then we have a task to do. So here you can see the floor. The floor tool returns the floor of the input element wise. Floor of the input element wise. The floor of x is the largest integer where I is largest integer I where I is less than equal to x. Okay, so here you can see import numpy, define an array. You can see each of the elements, they are float. Now if you will apply numpy dot floor to this array, you will get 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 time. You can see it's a largest integer I. These are I less than x is your these guys, okay, element wise it is applying. Element wise this will be largest integer, less than this guy will be 1.1 will be 1, similarly 7.7 will be 7, like this. So it selects the floor value, floor just like your room's floor, you can think downwards value, that is something you can imagine. Ceil value is the reverse of it, ceiling it chooses. The tool ceil returns the ceiling of the input element wise. Ceiling of x is the smallest integer I where I is greater than equal to x. Okay, just reverse of this guy. Ceiling you can imagine like your room ceiling, top value, right? So import numpy, this is an array defined. If you'll apply numpy dot ceil my array, you can see the integer which is greater than this smallest integer greater than this number is 2, then smallest integer greater than this guy is 3, likewise you can imagine here. Okay, so this is your floor and ceil. What about rint? Rint rounds to the nearest integer of input element wise, so it does the round off type of thing. Okay, so if you have an array like this, it round off each element. Okay, round off to 1, 2, 3, 4, then 6, you can see here. So 5.5 goes to 6, round offs to 6 rather than 5. Then 6.6 is 7, then 7.7 is 8, 8.8 is 9, 9.9 is 10. So it rounds off the value element wise to the nearest integer. Okay, it could be less or more. Now we have learned about all these three tools. Now let's see what is our task. We are given a 1D array A. Your task is to print the floor, ceil, and rint of all the elements of A. Simple. And here a note point is given. For correct output format, you have to add this line below numpy import here. Okay, so we will see without printing and with printing this line, what is the difference. Input format will be a single line of input containing the space separated elements of array A, nothing new, and we have to print floor, ceil, and rint. Okay, this is the kind of input will be given, and this is the floor, ceil, rint, round of integer, you can imagine like that. So first I'll take the input. Okay, let me call it A. Same stuff I'll do what we have done before, list, map. Now here the values are float. Okay, so float I'll take, float input dot split. Okay, like this. So this is our input. Now let me convert into array because that is the list above. So numpy dot array, and you can write A, right? Now we just have to print these guys, whatever we had here. This, so inside this bracket we have this, and this is your A, and let's take this whole thing. Is there any problem? Now control V, but instead of floor here we have ceil. Similarly, here we have r int. Let's run it. So the output is not in correct format. You can see there is some sort of a spacing between the output's elements, you can see here. Okay, but here we don't have it. So that is because we have not written this line. Okay, let me write it below numpy. So numpy set print options legacy equals 1.13, right? Single inverted comma also will work, double will also work. Let me write single only. Okay, so now things will be correct. So you can see, congratulations, spacing is now, it's there. So it's for correct format only. Let me submit it. All the test cases are passed. And congratulations. Okay, so we are done with this exercise. Let's go to the next one.